Imagine one day you accidentally walk into a castle, and upon walking in, you are greeted by a sign. The sign says, "This castle is filled with knights and knaves. Knights always tell the truth, while knaves always lie." Curious, you keep walking forward, and you are suddenly stopped by three figures, which you will denote as X, Y, and Z, as we do not yet know whether or not they are a knight or a knave. In an effort to figure out who is what, you ask all three of them if they are a knight or a knave. And although they don't directly answer your question, they give you the following statements. Person X states, "I am a knight and Y is a knave." Person Y states, "Z is a knight or X is a knight." Person Z states, "X is a knave." How do you go about figuring out who is a knight and who is a knave? One approach we can try is to assume that the first person we speak to, person X, is a knight, and work out the logic from there. But this trial and error approach can be time consuming, and get convoluted the more people we have. Currently we have three people, which gives us eight possible combinations of knights and knaves, and if we were to add more people into the mix, the number of possibilities inflates rather quickly, exponentially quickly to be exact, so it is best if we tackle this problem with a different approach. One approach we can take is through propositional logic. Propositional logic involves using logical notation to solve statements or propositions that are either true or false. Since the three people before us have statements that are either true or false, this is a perfect example of when to use propositional logic. Some of the logical notation involves the not, and, or, and the biconditional or if and only if logical operators. There are more, but for now, these are the only ones we need to use to figure out who the knights and knaves are. To see how these logical operators work, say we have a single variable A that can be either true or false. If A is true, it will be true, and if it is false, it will trivially be false. Now, if we were to put the not operator in front of the variable A, then we would have a logical expression that would be false when A is true, and true when A is false. The not operator can be thought of as a negation of a logical expression. Let's add another variable into the mix, B, to see how the and, or, and biconditional operators work. If A and B are true, then the statement is true. But when A is true and B is false, then the entire statement is false. The only time the statement is true is when both A and B are true. If at least one statement is false, the entire statement is false as well. The OR operator works similarly, except that if at least one statement is true, then the entire statement is true. The biconditional is a little bit trickier, as if both A and B are false, then the statement is true. But why is this? This is because the biconditional can be essentially thought of as an equal sign. And if both A and B are the same thing, then the statement will come out as true, with the statement only being false when the two variables are different things. One way to organize these logical expressions is with something called a truth table. These truth tables are like spreadsheets that help us keep track of statements when certain variables are either true or false. Truth tables can get messy, but they can also reveal valuable information to those with experienced eyes. Now that we understand these logical operators, we can immediately begin to use them to swap out certain words from the statement to make a logical expression that can either be true or false. If we break down one of these expressions, what is in the parentheses is the original statement said by the knight or knave, and then the biconditional is used to ensure that if a person is a knight and their statement is true, then the expression comes out as true, as they are a truth-telling knight. And if the person is a knave and the statement is false, the expression still comes out as true, as they are a lying knave, which correlates with the conditions of the problem. What we are trying to look for is a combination where all of the statements set by our knights or knaves are true. Now normally, you would need to work all of these logical expressions by hand one by one. It's 2024 and we have technology, so we can throw these statements into a truth table to help us find the right combination of knights and knaves. In the first row, our first three slots are our variables X, Y, and Z, and after that are our logical expressions. Each of these variables can be true or false, so we keep track of that with the columns below the variables, and then we keep track of whether our statements are true or false under the expression columns. Now we just have to look for the row where all our expressions are true, and that will reveal who is a knight or true, and who is a knave or false. If we look at the row with all trues for the logical expression, we can see that X is a knave, while Y and Z are our knights. I will leave the verification that this combination works as an exercise for the watcher. Yes, I am indeed giving you homework. Thank you for watching my introduction to propositional logic.